Hello everyone. In your previous class, we talked about different methods of separating the substances. Now, we will talk about another method of separating the substances, which is known as sieving. What is sieving? Sieving is a process which is used to separate minute particles of different sizes by passing it through a sieve. What is a sieve? Sieve is a device which has tiny holes in it which allows the finer particles through it to go through it, and the heavier and the bigger particles remain above it. Such process is used to filter flour and to remove the pebbles and stones from sand by a mason. Next step we will talk about is sedimentation and decantation. In sedimentation, the heavier component in a mixture settles after the water is added to it. That means the process in which the heavier component in a mixture settles down after the addition of water is known as sedimentation. And when the water is removed, the process is known as decantation. This is a quick but a rough method for separating a mixture of liquid and undissolved solid. So in case of liquid and undissolved solid, we will use sedimentation and decantation, in which firstly we add water, and after the heavier component settles down, the water is removed. Here are some examples of sedimentation and decantation. Like, mixture of sand and water is taken in a beaker and allowed to stand for some time. You will see that sand, being heavier, settles down at the bottom of the beaker. This is known as sedimentation. Now take another beaker and put a glass rod in a slanting position. Now slowly take the first beaker and pour the water gently on the glass rod. This transfer of water is called decantation. In such process, we get sand and water separate. Another example of such separation is filtration. Filtration is commonly used for the separation of solids from fluids. Fluids, or you can call liquids or gases, by interposing a medium through which only the fluid can pass. Here are some examples. As you can see, this is a coffee filter which is used to separate coffee flavor from coffee beans. Next process is evaporation. As you know, that process of evaporation is very essential in water cycle. And what happens in evaporation? The water boils and turns into steam, or you can say water vapors. The boiling point of a liquid is the minimum temperature at which the liquids begins to boil, and we all know that the boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius. After reaching this temperature and we still heat it, the water turns into vapor. So to separate the impurities from water, we boil it up to its boiling point and still keeps boiling, so that the water vapors the water converts into water vapors and is col and the impurities are left behind, and those water vapors are passed through a glass and then they settle down and cool down and give us water. The process in which a mixture is separated by heating a solution and then condensing using a cooling tube is known as distillation. Distillation is the process in which we get pure water or some other pure substances. For example, as you can see in these pictures, water is taken in a distillation flask and heated. The water boils and turns into vapor, and then it is collected in another flask called condenser. The vapor get condensed to the water, and this water is the purest water. It is free from any salt. This pure water is called distilled water. And distilled water is used in preparation of medicines. That's how you can see that how important is the separation of substances from the impurities.